Second very important thing which I really want to share with you, and you will enjoy this the most, okay? Identifying the types of people. Now, there are a lot of personality or tests and tools and all those things, but let's talk practical, because I have worked with people and I have observed certain things from them. Based on that, I have created something which I will share with you, and I would like you to really look at this and understand how it, and believe me, you will start seeing faces now when I share this with you, this concept. Okay. So there are four types of momentum makers, takers, breakers, and I will share what it is. There are four types of people in the organization. The first type of people in the organization, we call them as momentum makers. Okay. Momentum makers are those people. They come up with new ideas. They are always ready to do something new. They are innovating. They are doing something better. They want to do better and better. Every time they are coming up with a lot of ideas, and they want to create that kind of atmosphere. They want everybody to move ahead. So that is what we call them as momentum makers. Now, in most of the cases, the momentum maker is always the owner of the organization or the business. Because he comes up, he attends all such kind of programs, and he wants to go and implement it in his business. So he's always there thinking of new things. But then when he's not getting the support, or when he's locked in those firefighting situations every day, his momentum also goes down. Okay. So if you, in your organization, if you, and you have certain people who are your momentum makers, your organization will keep on growing. And that is the first part. Identifying the momentum makers who are driving your organization, who are coming up with new ideas to make your organization go to a different height. So that is the first part. Now, there also would be some people whom we call as momentum takers. Now, they may not be good with ideas, but they are very sincere. They are ready to take responsibilities. They are there to give the 100% and they are committed. So when you tell them to do something, they will go out of the way to complete that project. And these people are called as momentum takers. So if you have some people in your organization who are at least momentum takers, still your organization is moving ahead and doing something great, which your organization can go to the next level. So we talked about two things, momentum maker and momentum taker. Let's look at another category. These people are called momentum breaker. They will sit in the meeting. They will listen to everything. They will know what plan, action, whatever has to be decided. But at the time of execution, they will always come up with excuses and all the reasons why it can't be done. How many of you have experienced such kind of situations in your life? Yeah, we would like to mute everyone, because it's disturbing others. So I would request everyone to be on mute, and we can use a chat box. How many of you have identified these characters, makers, takers, and breakers in the organizations? Most of us would have seen this kind of situations around us. Okay, we would have experienced it, I'm sure. So yes, very good. So we had three: maker, taker, and breaker. Now let's come to the most dangerous. And they are called as momentum fakers. These fakers, especially in the small organizations, these fakers are people who are very close to you. They create an aura around them in such a way that in Hindi we say, "Iske bagar mera patta bhi nahi hilta," because he is the whole and soul. Whatever he says is done. So he creates an aura in such a way that he feels that he is the only person who is driving this organization. And one of the challenge with this person is he will never allow anybody to rise to a certain level. He will always try to put him down. He will always interfere with the decision-making process, and he will not allow them to communicate with you as an owner. So he will always create a barrier in the communication. These are the people who are actually harming the organizations And these people could be your old employees when you took them, when you started your business, you had nobody and he supported you. So that emotional connect is so high that you don't feel like letting him go. But friends, this person is actually creating a challenge for you in the organization and it is not allowing your business to grow. How many of you could understand what I'm saying? And most of the time, best of the people leave the organization because of these fakers. Because they manipulate most of the time. Yeah, the breakers are people who are low on motivation. They are not action takers. So they want always to remain in the comfort zone. And that's the reason why they are not taking any action. They are not responsible. They will not complete the task on time. And they will give all kinds of excuses to tell you why this cannot be done. So this is what happens. Four types of people: maker, taker, breaker, and faker. Now, the moment you start implementing systems, processes, and when you start putting in all the compliances, the first thing that happens is faker will automatically move out because now he understands ki abhi yahan meri dal galne wali nahi hai. Now nobody will give me that importance and slowly, slowly he starts moving out and then the breaker would become little more involved in the process and slowly, slowly he has the potential and he also can become a taker. So that's the whole journey. And this is a process that we need to take people through. So it would not happen immediately in 1 or 2 days. But if I set a process, then everybody can at least reach to the level of taker. And once they take control and responsibility of the task, of the work that is there, automatically our organization from running, it starts growing. How many of you can connect to this? Is it making sense what I'm saying? Is it making sense? Because this is what practically we have done in organizations and we have seen, especially with the entrepreneurs, this is what has happened. And then they, once they get time to focus on the revenue generating activities. Today, they are stuck with non-revenue generating activities. And then they say that my business is not growing. I'm not getting the expected results because he's not focusing on the activities which is revenue generating. And these people will help him to focus on revenue generating activities. And this is where probably people who said that we are on 5 and 6, okay, bottom three, probably they are doing this with their people. And that's why they have reached and their organization is growing every year.